Chapter 2 Natural Resources. Points to learn. Natural resources. Number 1. Land resources and land use. Number 2. Water resources. Number 3. Soil resources. Number 4. Forests and wildlife. Number 5. Mineral resources. Learning outcomes. After learning this chapter, you will get the following information. Number 1. Introduction of natural resources. Number 2. Information of land use in Maharashtra. Number 3. Availability, use and pollution of water. Number 4. Importance of conservation of water. Number 5. Various types of soil. Number 6. Information of conservation of soil. Number 7. Types of forests and importance of forests. Number 8. Conservation of forests and animals. Number 9. Distribution of minerals. Number 10. Need of conservation of minerals. What is a resource? Any type of material and form of energy that we use in our life for making it easy and comfortable can be called as a resource. However, it is necessary that the said materials or energy is technologically available and economically viable. We use different minerals as raw materials in various industries. These minerals existed as earth materials since they were formed. However, these remained as unutilized resources. They became resources only after the appropriate technology was developed. Similarly, the biogas that we use as energy resource existed since long, but it became a resource only when the technology to use it was developed. The resources that we obtain from nature are called natural resources. Using these, we may get involved in developing some facilities such as power generation, industries, transport, etc. Such facilities may be considered as man-made resources. The development of a region basically depends on the availability of resources and its proper and judicious utilization. In this chapter, we shall be discussing the natural resources available in Maharashtra and the manner in which they are put to use. Of the natural resources, we shall be collecting information on land, water, soil, forest, and mineral resources in the state. While discussing each of these natural resources, we shall note that the typical characteristics of these resources which limit or enhance their utilizations. Land resources and land use. In this section, we shall be discussing the land resources and land use in Maharashtra. Total area of Maharashtra state is 3,07,580 square kilometers. Agriculture claims maximum proportion of the land resources. Hence, we shall discuss the availability of land resources in the state with reference to agriculture. The availability of land for agriculture depends on the relief and slope of the land. Its utility for agriculture largely depends on rainfall and soil conditions. See the map of physiography and drainage given in figure 1.3. Also study the rainfall map given in this book. They will give some idea about the constraint of using the land resource particularly for agriculture. Land of Konkan and the Western Ghats has high relief and steep slope. This limits the availability of land for agriculture. In the eastern parts of the state, the availability of land for agriculture is less because of the competition with other uses such as forest and mining activity. The central Maharashtra receives low rainfall, although this does not directly restrict the availability of land. Its usability for agriculture gets considerably reduced. The areas of floodplains of the major rivers in the state like Tapi, Godavari, Wardha Vai Ganga, Bhima and Krishna are the regions having better land resource potentials as far as the agriculture is concerned. Fallow land. Fallow lands are classified into two groups. The lands that can never be used for cultivation are called permanent fallows. Due to heavy downpour, topsoil layers get removed and land becomes permanently unsuitable for cultivation. Similarly, some areas turn into marshy lands due to water logging. Particularly, Khar land in Konkan coastal region can be considered as permanent fallows. Large portion of cultivated area in Maharashtra totally depends on rainfall. In a year, if rainfall is not adequate for sowing, land is not cultivated. Such lands are termed current fallow lands. Efforts are required to bring such land under cultivation if irrigation is made available. Similarly, these lands can be used for fruit gardening or forestry plantation. The land use in a region is an outcome of the interaction between peasant community and physical conditions controlling agrarian activity. However, with changing time, needs of the society varies. The technological development in agriculture equips farming community to intensively use the resources and global market conditions dictate farmer to choose new crops. All these factors cause changes in land use pattern. A change in land use pattern also leads to a chain of changes in socio-environmental problems. Land use. The term land use relates to the purposes to which land in a given region is put to use. We can have general land use, urban land use, agricultural land use, etc. Forest, agriculture, settlement, industrial estates, etc. are some of the purposes considered in general land use of a region. The use of land for these different purposes in a region and the extent of land used for each of these purposes defines the pattern of land use in any region. The general land use of the state as whole has been given in Figure 2.1. It shows the percentages of the land used for categories like forest, net shown area, area not available for agriculture and fallow land. The proportion of the land used for each of these purposes varies considerably in different districts. This has been shown in the figure 2.2, depicting land use pattern of each district. Using this, study the patterns of land use categories. Net sown area. In Maharashtra, 56.6% land area is used for agriculture is known as cultivated land. Physical setup, climate, soils, irrigation facilities, gradient of area affect the land under cultivation. Western Maharashtra and Vidarbha has 70% area under cultivation. In Konkan, and eastern Vidarbha, area's gradient is steep and land is covered by forests. Hence, the areas under cultivation are relatively low. Due to increasing population and urbanization, agricultural land around urban area is shrinking. Non-agricultural use of land. The land which is not used for agriculture is known as non-agricultural use of land. Land is particularly used for residential and settlement purpose. There is a rapid growth in industrialization and urbanization in Maharashtra. The percentage of non-agricultural land is increasing. Water resources. For entire biosphere, water is the most essential resource. It is one of the basic needs of all the life forms. Its availability in any region is largely determined by climatic conditions of the region. We get water in the form of rainfall, and it is the only source of usable water on the earth. However, rainfall, though it is the source of water by itself, does not become a water resource. It needs to be collected, stored, and then supplied to various climates of water resource. Water is a renewable resource. Being liquid in nature, it can be transported from one place to another by canals or through pipes. Water is used by humans for a large number of activities. We use water mainly for agriculture, industries, as well as for our domestic needs. Besides these, water is used for power generation, transportation, recreation, etc. Water resources in Maharashtra. In Maharashtra, distribution of rainfall is not uniform, and it ranges from more than 3000 mm in Western Ghats region to less than 450 mm in rain shadow area of the Ghats. See the map of rainfall distribution in Maharashtra given in figure 1.4. About 80% of rainfall in Maharashtra is concentrated in 4 months of monsoon. This leads to scarcity condition in the rest of the period. Hence, it is necessary to store water and use it judiciously for the entire year. Water resources in Maharashtra can be grouped into two categories, such as surface water and ground water. The water which flows through the river channels and gets collected in lakes or is stored in reservoirs is termed as surface water. The water that is percolated into the ground and gets stored at deeper depths in the ground is termed as ground water. Basalt rock in Maharashtra is such that it does not allow much of the water to percolate. The dams having height of 10 meters and above are called large dams. Maharashtra has highest number of large dams in the country. There are more than 1,800 major dams in Maharashtra. The total gross storage of these dams is over 37 billion cubic meters. Of course, each year one may not have this much of storage. It depends on the rainfall in a given year. Besides these major dams, there are large number of medium and small dams as well as bunds storing huge quantity of water. The groundwater available in the state is estimated to be 32.96 BCM. Of course, the groundwater is not available in the same quantity in different parts. The hilly region of Western Ghats receives more rain, but due to the steep slope, percolation rate is quite low. In central Maharashtra, as the rainfall is less, the groundwater potential is also low. Comparatively, in the low-lying areas within the river basins, groundwater is more. Water scarcity. Agriculture in Maharashtra is totally dependent on rainfall. Only 17% of area is irrigated and 83% of area is depending on rainfall. In Maharashtra, more than 62,000 square kilometers area is drought-prone zone. Ahmednagar, Pune, Satara, Sangli, Osmanabad and Dhule districts of Maharashtra come under drought-prone zone. Area which frequently faces drought conditions is called drought-prone area. As and when rainfall is scanty leads to water scarcity conditions. Under such conditions, wells dry out, creating problems for agriculture. This leads to decrease in agricultural products. Water pollution. When the quality of water decreases, it becomes unusable. This process is called water pollution. Water gets contaminated or polluted by sewage water, industrial water, animal wastes, waste water from sugar factory, fertilizer factory, garbage, paper and plastic industries, etc. Drinking water gets contaminated due to the mixing of chromium, sodium, mercury, copper, etc. Hyacinth plant spread over water bodies and percentage of oxygen falls. Water becomes dark black in color. If such water gets mixed with the drinking water, it leads to spread of diseases. Water conservation. Rainwater is a main source of water in Maharashtra. Maximum area of Maharashtra is under drought-prone area. So it is necessary to conserve water. Water can be saved by the following methods. Number 1. Care should be taken that every drop of water percolates into the ground. Number 2. Bunds should be constructed on smaller streams, percolation tanks, village tanks, farm tanks, etc. Number 3. The dams should be dredged to increase the storage capacity. They should be repaired to prevent leakage. Number 4. Social awareness must be created to save water. Number 5. Rainwater harvesting plan should be followed. Number 6. Forest conservation plan should be implemented to conserve water. Our state has the largest number of major dams, over 1,800. Large dams, though provide irrigation water for large extent of areas, the huge storage of water in reservoirs leads to some environmental as well as social problems. Besides the problem of displacement of population due to the construction of such dams, the flow conditions in the channel downstream the dam and changed to considerable extent and the river regime in these parts changes. The river ecosystems in downstream areas get threatened due to lowering of discharges. Irrigation. If the water required by a crop cannot be fulfilled by the rainwater, it becomes necessary to supply water by artificial means. Such a supply of water through artificial means is called irrigation. In Maharashtra, well irrigation is a prime source of irrigation. Following statistical information indicates the different sources of irrigation. Table number 2.1. Maharashtra, irrigation 2009 to 2010. Number 1. Means of irrigation, well irrigation. Percentage 55.0. Number 2, means of irrigation, canal irrigation, percentage 22.5. Number 3, means of irrigation, tank irrigation, percentage 14.5. Number 4, means of irrigation, lift irrigation, percentage 8.0. Total 100%. Number 1. Well irrigation. Well irrigation is a private source of irrigation. Well irrigation covers maximum area of irrigation in Maharashtra. In Konkan, very limited area is under well irrigation. In Ahmednagar district, largest number of wells are found. Of the total irrigated area, the share of well irrigation is 55%. Number 2. Canal irrigation. Majority of the dams in Maharashtra are constructed for irrigation purpose. Out of the total area under irrigation, 22.5% area is irrigated by canals. Western Maharashtra is suitable for irrigation projects because the rivers rise along the eastern slope of the Western Ghats. These are east flowing rivers. Large number of dam sites are available on the eastern slope. Number 3. Tank irrigation. In the eastern Maharashtra, Chandrapur, Bhandara, Gondia, Gadchiroli districts, tank irrigation is the main source of irrigation. In Maharashtra, 14.5% area is irrigated by this system. Sprinklers and drip irrigation are water-saving methods of irrigation. They save 40% of water. Drip water irrigation supplies water to the roots of the plants. It saves not only water, but also fertilizers. Available water resources can be utilized for 2.5 times more area. Only required amount of water is used in sprinklers. Number 4. Lift irrigation. When the area is higher than the source of water, it is required to lift water from the source for irrigation. This type of irrigation is known as lift irrigation. The basic source of water may be river, tank, or dams. Water is unable to reach farms by the surface canal. Hence, it needs to be lifted. In Maharashtra, 8% of irrigated area is under lift irrigation. Demand for water is continuously increasing due to the increasing population, irrigation, and industrial growth. While supplying water, priority is given for the drinking water and remaining water is used for irrigation and industrial sectors. Soil resources. Soil is basically a mixture of weathered rocks, mineral nutrients, decaying organic matter, water, air, and variety of organisms. Soil is considered to be a perfect ecosystem. Plants use soil as an ecosystem, not as material. Soil is a key component of biodiversity of a region next only to climate. It is a base of all life on land. Plants get their nutrients from soil. Soil is an essential resource for entire vegetal world on the land. The soil forming processes are quite slow and hence the soil becomes a non-renewable resource. It is not a material that can be produced artificially in laboratories. Being a prime resource and the base of the life of land, it is necessary that soils are properly managed against the loss of this resource through erosion or degradation due to improper and excessive use. Types of soils. Based on type of rock, climate of the region, and the duration of period of soil formation, we come across different types of soils. Black soil. Black soil is formed due to weathering of basalt rock. Since this soil contains titanic ferrous magnetite, it is black in color. This soil consists of iron, lime, potash, aluminium, calcium, and magnesium carbonate. Black soil is deficient of nitrogen, phosphorus, and organic matter. This soil is also called as rigor soil. This soil is very fertile due to its moisture contents. In Maharashtra, black cotton soil is mainly found in Amravati, Akola, Buldhana, Vashim, Parbhani, Dhule, Jalgaon, Hingoli, Osmanabad, Ahmednagar districts of Maharashtra. This soil is suitable for crops like cotton, sugarcane, fruits, wheat, jawar, and pulses. Red and yellowish soil. In Maharashtra, red and yellowish soil is formed from weathering of ancient granite and gneiss rocks. This soil is red in color due to the iron compound. In some places, this soil is formed in yellow, brown, and gray colors. The soil lacks in phosphoric acid, organic matter, lime, and nitrogen. The soil is found in Nagpur, Bhandara, Gondia, Chandrapur, and Gadchiroli district. Crops like bajra, groundnut, potato, and rice grow well in this soil.